as they don't get distracted by the noise. Just hear God. Peter answered him and said, Lord, if thou would bid me to come to thee on the water. What Peter was really doing was trying to get him to speak. I need to hear his voice. I need to hear who it really is. The Bible says in John 10:27, my sheep know my voice, and a stranger they will not follow. And see, there's a reason why Peter wanted to hear the voice of God, because everybody thought it was a ghost. But I found that my wife knows my voice, and my daughter knows my voice. And when you've been in a relationship with somebody, when they speak, you know who they are. Don't be distracted by the noise. Now, when Peter was come down to the ship, he walked on the water to go to Jesus. But when he saw the wind boisterous, he was afraid. After my father passed of cancer at 33, I was concerned then, and I was concerned at the age of 29, because I was concerned about the simple fact that this thing would happen to me. My father passed early, I might pass early, but then I began to establish a relationship with God. I begin to call on my Savior. I begin to call upon Him for questions that I didn't know the answers to. Well, God, why would you do this? God, what would you do that? And then God began to deal with me. He began to let me know. Through relationship, fear nothing. Fear not man, but just follow my word. I'll lead you and guide you. Just listen to what I'm saying. Don't worry about the noise. Don't worry about what they say. Forget about the way they look. Forget about the way they appear. Just follow my voice. Don't get distracted by what people are saying. Don't worry about, even if it looks bad. I am with you even until the end. Look at your neighbor and say, don't get distracted by the noise. What did God say? Don't get distracted by the noise. Because Satan is coming to tempt. He's coming to bring you down. He's coming to work through your body to get you to walk in the wrong direction. Put it in check. Speak that word. And when you speak that word, the devil got to come suck you. Jesus was up on a hill. He spoke that word. He let him know, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that exceeded out of the mouth of God. Remove from me. We got to live by this word. We got to stand by this word. We got to put this flesh in check. Because if you don't do that, you can't love me. You definitely can't love the unlovable. Because if your flesh ain't together, you can't love those that don't love you. God saying, I got to work for you. But you got to get yourself together. You got to get down in those sackcloth and ashes. You got to get yourself to a place where I can move through you. God is looking for a vessel that he can use. He can't use you if you're caught up in yourself. Amen. Amen. That is all. Everybody say, don't get distracted by the noise. Amen. Put your hands together and give God some praise.